Kazak. I don't know why I decided to record all of a sudden. I hope that you guys cannot pick up this echo. But I will be playing a doubleheader against Satanus. So I hope you enjoy. First one is Dead Man's Torment. I probably am not going to need two Dragon Tooth, so that's going to be my first sack. Okay. Probably Rampage. My hope is probably K Confluence turn 5 along with a crippling blow, but we'll see. Also, sorry if I don't talk too much. I'm getting an echo. I'm sorry. You probably aren't because I have a headset, but it is annoying me a bit. Also, I think I need to message Avier. Okay, that changes things. Looks like I'm going to need to CB that because he can just outright kill things. Don't think Sorcerer is going to be that big a contributor here. It should be ready to kill that next turn. That's nasty. I guess one Spirit Morden because I need the draw. I'm gonna need the Dragon Tooth, and if he's running Zales him, I'm going to need the Legend Rises, so not ideal at all. Do not know why he played that after he attacked. Definitely should have played that before. Looks like I should sack the Legend Rises. play the champion. However, that causes problems later. Still thinks it's my best play. The other option was just sacking nothing or the champion. Didn't really like either of those options much. Is so he's got second draw, that's not fun. Right. Looks like I'm going to have to kill just retreat just a car. That puts a lot of eggs in one basket, though. If he just mass purifications, but I'm not doing particularly well right now, so I need to get this up. Swing first. Doesn't really matter because he'd have the things, but just have it. All right, that's fairly whittled down. Ooh, that was a good draw. Mass purification is still going to be not fun at all. It would let him clear either of my allies and get rid of both draw engines, but at least I'll have another. Okay, I was kind of hoping he'd do that. Let's just lay down a sandworm. Other option was play a dragon tooth and just attack him with it to break his staff, but not a ghost. Kill one. And then the CB plus Alden. Doesn't sound great, but like I'm setting myself up for a tidal wave there. No, I definitely want to attack him. Break his wizens. So definitely CB Alden. Sandworm, attack him. That was a mistake. 100% should have killed that first, and that one damage may end up costing me. We'll see. But I really can't afford to do that. Not against a good player like this. I'm fairly happy with that. Think get rid of one Aeon, put down the Dragon Tooth. Don't play any allies so I don't overexpand into a tidal wave, and I can clear this. Now, unfortunately, he could always focus prayer plus drop his fatty. But ooh. Don't need to hold on to two of those. And I don't want to play anything either because I want to have cards freed up. Is it worth killing that? Four damage hit opposed to six. But I'd be spending six damage to kill him. Probably still is worth it. In part because this way I can always hit him with Dragon Tooth as well. It does not look like he's getting much. I think he's just waiting for a tidal wave. Maybe a weapon. I think I'm gonna swing here. Also, I'm gonna play Sorcerer Threat and Lethal. If he doesn't have a tidal wave, he dies, and I wanted to clear space anyway because I just have to draw two cards. But it looks like I just lucked out this game. Again, I don't need two of those. That's Aeon plus Champion. See if he tidal waves again. I actually like my hand a lot. So I'll just live with not drawing the extra card. And I'm going to take out the rod completely in this round. And I'm not going to play anything because I'm throwing lethal next turn anyway. So there's no reason to overexpand into a tidal wave. Confluence was actually probably a safe sack. But no need to do it now. There's no point. So it's going to be Sandworm. Champion. CB. And then I'm hopefully playing King's Pride and killing him next turn, but we'll see. Looking for a tidal wave, yep. That would be 13. I can't get to that high. Visca's Spirit Warden is just the best bet here. What's the max he can hit for? If he plays Rod of Smiting plus Justicar, that's 4, 6. Yeah, that's fine. Not lethal. I might have needed to play KP A to prevent that, but I think the most damage he can do does not kill me. I mean, I guess triple smite, but I can't really defend against that anyway. And looks like I lucked that one out. He should be creating. Oh no, I went second actually. Right, so I need to create. I'll just message him, let him know it's up. Give me a minute. Oh, nope, he found out. Think Rampage again. Yari's not particularly good here either, because based off his deck, it doesn't look like he's going to really have three, but I'll hold on to that for now. Yeah, that's now going to be my attack. It's too killable by his weapons, and it's just not. I guess maybe. Let's get a retreat for now. Spirit Warden. Hopefully next turn drop another Spirit Warden and turn 5 Confluence plus Scrippling Blow again. course, that could happen. So I need to skip my resource step. Take that out. So unfortunately now I'm pretty expanded into a tidal wave. Also, I probably should not have attacked him with champion because on the off chance he would have played another ally, I'm now lost to damage, but it didn't matter. Well, he killed the champion anyway. Spirit Warden, I guess. Now I have to attack with champion first to kill this because will die since that dies. I could have also. Couldn't even. So that was a mistake. I forgot he had that still up. At this point, I will attack him with Spirit Warden also. This is actually important because Avengers, I don't want them to be 4/4s. But I will attack him with Spirit Warden also because he's probably going to clear that and I want his wizards to break. So, looking back, I probably wouldn't have attacked with either. Don't like this play at all, though I still think it's right. Okay, that's the card I needed. Also, it doesn't look like he's running Mass Purification because he did not show it last game. I guess swing, but not fun. I think he probably has this game. Ooh. He's running those then. is not particularly helpful here. I don't like doing this. Because it's just not a good time. Oh, wow. This is not the draft I want. Completely his game. That will help a bit, though. It's funny, I thought he would never get the three allies, so I just got rid of that Yari marksman. I mean, by the time he did, it was useful, but still. Still need two more frenzies. Take that out. Man, that's a lot of them. If he plays Justicar, I think that's game. I mean, not instantly, but the amount of health I'll lose will be pretty irrecoverable. That's 4, 10, 12 damage. Then I get a tick from Blood Frenzy. No, that's there. Oh well. Still, that was actually Not far off. I may have a chance on this one. That'll hurt. But we'll see. Ooh, no champion. Yeah, I don't think I have this game. Well. Let's hope for the best. Big thing last game is I lost my board by attacking into him when I shouldn't have. I actually might just do, yeah. Because of that, think I'm just going to do a turn two Blood Frenzy. Turn two Blood Frenzy, and then turn three Marksman Plus ability. Though he might just play a Wizens, which would still not be bad for me. That down. I need to kill Sindarik because he just hits too hard. Or she, I guess. Interesting. I really want to play Champion plus Alden, though I feel like I'm playing too much into Light if I do that, so I'm gonna just drop down the Sandworm. And probably Dragon Tooth next turn. Definitely gonna break the Wizards. Or not. He's gonna force my hand here. So he's gonna draw plus Tidal Wave. not pleasant, but he'd get the card anyway because I was playing. I mean, playing a Templar would have given him board, so that would just not be good. Still, I'll have a full hand after the tidal wave. That's not at all bad. Sorry about the telegram pop-ups. Actually, I'm curious if I am even playing a doubleheader now, because if he started the next round, that means one of us lost. Although, if he knows that we're playing. Yeah, okay. He knows we're doing the doubleheader. Hope his connection's okay. I'll give him a. I'm a little worried because it's stuck on his sacrifice and. Ooh. I'll message him on Telegram. Yes, message me. Yeah, he's got turn six by me. That's not. Oh well. And now he's gonna get to go first again. That's not really fortunate. I really liked my board. He was forced to tidal wave there. I still had a full hand. Nope, that was dumb. All right, well, let's see how this compares to last hand. Champion, that's not bad. No draw, but we'll see. Nice. This could actually work out really well for me. And looks like it is. I'm gonna go and get rid of the Spirit Warden, actually. Probably play Blood Frenzy next turn. Probably sack an Aeon over a Sandworm. And yeah, Alden's not going to help me here. So I lost board. Well, not completely. He has to play a Templar, which would make Champion survive, actually. Oh, no, Wizens. Still not too bad. And it's oddly true. It was a really crappy situation for it. But he did play it right. Now, the funny thing is, I can't actually kill Syndrick. He's probably gonna kill the Alden. Yeah. Still think drop a sandworm. Confluence, I guess, not really ideal. Let's take that out. Alden plus Seductress next turn. Should set me up back with a good board. Still would have preferred to be able to play around the Mass Purification, though I don't think he has it, and I couldn't play around it. Not easily, anyway. All right, let's walk into a tidal wave. This sounds fun. Or I'm better off not sacking anything. Still somewhat walking into a tidal wave because I'm spending the same number of cards. But at least I don't need to sack anything to do it. Because sandworms are going to be the big players this game. Actually, I'm not going to get rid of Rampage. I guess Aeon. If nothing else, I can Seductress plus pump Seductress. The sandworm would have been a nice play there too. Not really sure which was better. It's going to be Seductress plus Pump Seductress. This puts me in a nice field position. If he tidal waves, I'm still in a really good spot. I think I want to retreat Rampage. So. Would have been nice if I could have broken Wizards there, but there was no nice way of doing that. He really needs to tidal wave again. Right. save my ability for one of the guys I actually need to kill. They buffed Dragontooth? When did they do that? I mean, I guess before Shadow Fates was released, but I oddly never knew that. I'm going to sack Blood Frenzy. Let's see, he can hit me for 4. Supposed to be up to 13. Oh, he didn't buff. This looks like it's my game. You need to do that. It feels dumb in so many ways. B I need to threaten lethal with KP. Okay. That's 3, 5. Not quite enough, but in a, every practical sense, it is. Because Dragon Tooth. Right. Well played, sir. Now I just need to switch decks. Yes, those were actually very good games. Slot one, I think. I do want to switch that and switch that for three ley line accesses. All right, so it does look like there won't be a doubleheader after all. So I'll just end here. Thank you for viewing.